Hello, and welcome to Gunpla Reviews, where it is myself versus my shelf. Almost 250 model kits, and a growing queue of reviews to do. Today's challenger in this new round is the high grade 144 scale Gundam Barbatos from Iron-Blooded Orphans, the Year of Our Bandai Lords, 2015. What am I hiding here? It's an autograph from Mikazuki's English voice actor. I was very lucky to get this autograph, as well as another kit that we will see later. The Queen of Space had bases and parts for the same voice actors to get autographs on. And as I know, I do believe this gentleman is also in 13 Sentinels. Where's my model kit? I digress. Let us behold the manual. And so, with that, we have the standard, very regular, everyday release, the original high-grade Gundam Barbatos 4th form. We'll be seeing a lot of the Barbatos in this round, but let's talk about this young lad right here, beginning with the articulation. Our head, up, down, that's a whole lot of down. I forgot it had that much down. Does. It's also very stiff. Look at that neck joint. That's why it's so stiff. A very unobstructed exorcist twist at the arms. Shoulder alone gets this high up. But it looks like, unless I'm doing something wrong. That's correct. Arm goes up this high. We'll have full rotation. The shoulder also moves up this way. So does that mean it does get up a bit higher with the shoulder out of the way? Bicep rotation. Locked. Locked and blocked. Very, very strange. But it also appears that, no, am I, this, what is the difference here? What mistake have I made? Is this piece on backwards? Is this a fixable piece? Let's take this off. Take a moment. Sit right there. And I'll show you how I became a complete idiot in live television. Which it's not actually live television, of course. This is a recording, and we're leaving this in because it's just more, it feels more natural, more real when it's like, oh, you fucked up live. And that was the move. I had this piece on backwards. Well, what do you know? For years, it's been in that state. Who'd have thought? Anyway, back on point, regular ball joint, now that the elbow is not obstructed. With the arms up, and you get a full exorcist twist because of the nature of this tiny Gundam frame. You do get some rocking back and forth at the chest. Side skirts, very small, easy to lift up out of the way. So we can see Oh yeah. This man flexing. Flexing on them high grades. Separatable. What is separatable? Separatable front skirt. So you get high power kick to the back. You don't really get much. Thus leading to fairly hardy knee bend. Well done. At the foot, we have powerful toe bend with this ankle armor also moving quite a bit. We get back and forth rocking. A lot of side action. Just because I'm looking at it one way doesn't mean the viewfinder's seeing it the same way I'm seeing it. So, really, it's got a whole lot of flexibility. And what's the term I'm looking for? Articulation is a word, but not the word I'm looking for. It's modular, I guess, is the term I'm looking for. I believe that's the term I was fishing for. It's modular. However, young lad is a bit on the sticker heavy side. All these, we're going to call them power symbols, over here on the knees, up here at the shoulder, on the chesto. But other than those stickers, and then your eyes deep in there, you've got some side skirt color correction. Both up. No, this is not a sticker. This red piece is not a sticker. This black piece is. These egregious stickers that cover both the side, then all the way along this edge. I hate those stickers. I think these are affixed with glue. Sometimes you just gotta put an adhesive on there and solve the problem. And then one last one, hiding. What are you focused on, camera? On the backpack. The backpack does have a bit of a gimmick going on. You separate this, and it will allow for when you choose to have other sets. You can plug in, and now we're moving on to accessories without announcement. Plug these into the back, and these will plug into various weapon expansions so that it will help carry many things. So we do this, and then I believe this will do something like so. And then a weapon, let's say, as I reach into a bag of secrets, this very long-barreled rifle this will mount down here. Turn that to the side for you. And that does indeed help hold such large armaments in place. And I did get the first weapon set for the Barbatos almost simultaneously. But we're not here to review the accessories. Not yet. Or rather, we're not here to review accessory sets just yet. That will come in time. In powerful, powerful time. Wanted to make sure y'all heard that. And then I popped the handle off like an idiot. I hope I didn't break it. Nah, it was just a scope. Just a scope. Okay, alright. Fix that. So, leaving this aside, I'm going to focus on the back of our model. You also get a hefty selection of pieces. I think some of these are extra, but there are long pieces that I'm trying to hold up without dropping, and shorter pieces, you know, adjustable length to help support armaments. Back here, you have a couple of clips, which can hold your large weapons. We have the pile bunker mace, which is, unfortunately, only three large pieces of plastic, with the pile driver up here at the tip, not really participating in the fun. You also get a regular metal katana. The Barbatos does not come with any ranged weapons, just blade and bludgeon. Or even this is still kind of a blade unto itself. However, it's not all it comes with. It has pieces and a suggestion for you that perhaps, because you find this at the very beginning of the show, and it's episode one, and you're just gonna kind of slap some extra parts on there to make sure it can go out to battle, you get an alternate arm with some extra plating on it, not unlike a shield. Now, the instructions, I believe, don't tell you that there's enough pieces that you can just yank the entire arm off and expect you to swap a few parts out, but there's enough pieces on the runner that you don't have to worry about that thing. As such, you just slide the mace in, and with ease, it can carry that weight. And with all of its posability, it can really carry that weight. The high-grade Gundam Barbatos began a new line, and it did a whole mountain of things absolutely correctly. Sure, it was the real push into DLC model kits, where a lot of the cool stuff that you're going to see in the show, especially for customizing both the regular and some of the grunt units, had to be purchased separately. But this on its own, with what you get in the box, everything you see here. And so, we here at Zeon will give this young lad an ace ranking. Even after 5 years, this really set a new standard in high grades. This brought high grades into something more respectable and visible. Even though it's always been the main line, I feel like before the high grade IBO line, master grades were what you're really looking for in a lot of like small details and flexibility, as well as what actually became a high grade inner skeleton thanks to the IBO line and the Barbatos himself. I was so glad to pick this up, like, week two, week three, whenever it was. It's just like, get in there, let's go. It's great. If you haven't already, the Barbatos is an amazing place to start if you're out there collecting new kits. It should still be in pretty regular circulation. It should be easy to find. And there's plenty of upgrades that come along to it, as well as one that we will see later on. But I thank y'all for watching. Stay tuned to this channel for more giant robot antics, model kit reviews, and soon video game reviews. And as always, good night, Space Lords.